Alright. Alright, so wait a second. The spirit wanted me to make this video. Man, my coffee. And so the spirit's always communicating with me. I'm always communicating with the spirit. Step by step. That's how these videos were created. And moving on. So all righteousness must be fulfilled. Do not withhold good from those to whom it is due, when it is in your power to do it. Do not say to your neighbor, go and come back, and tomorrow I will give it, when you have it with you. Do not devise evil against your neighbor who lives securely beside you. Do not devise evil against your neighbor who lives securely beside you. Do not devise evil against your neighbor who lives securely beside you. Do not quarrel with a man without cause, if he has done you no harm. Do not envy a man of violence, and do not choose any of his ways. For the devious are repulsive to the Lord, but his private counsel is with the upright, those with spiritual integrity and moral courage. He blesses the home of the just and righteous, though he scoffs at the scoffers and scorns the scorners. Yet he gives his grace, his undeserved favor, to the humble, those who give up self-importance. The wise will inherit honor and glory, but dishonor and shame is conferred on fools. Hear, O children, the instruction of the Father. And pay attention and be willing to learn so that you may gain understanding and intelligent discernment. For I give you good doctrine. Do not turn away from my instruction. When I was a son with my father, David, tender and the only son in the sight of my mother, Bathsheba, he taught me and said to me, let your heart hold fast my words, keep my commandments, and live. Get skillful and godly wisdom. Acquire understanding. Actively seek spiritual discernment, mature comprehension, and logical interpretation. Amen. So, the spirit wanted me to go into a certain subject. I've been led to learn about this for about the last 3 years, and I've gone piece by piece, tracing things back and understanding things. And it all started, the spirit led me to learn about a lost tribe of Israel that is and was in Ethiopia. They found one of the Ark of the Covenants, and it was a drum. It is a drum. It is a drum. It is a drum. So, like I always do, the spirit wanted me to tell you this story. So, when I was in junior high through high school, and it seems to always start for a man, and this is biblical, when he turns 13, you make certain decisions for your life. And this has got to be said, but I don't want to disrespect anybody, and please don't be offended. It's just the truth and how I grew up, and it answers a lot of questions. And there is an importance to it. So when I was in junior high, my junior high. During the time, because it no longer exists, but it was very gang affiliated. And one of the necklaces people would wear would have a certain star on it. And then your dad had to be from a certain lineage to be a part of this. And then, of course, you had to know your literature, things like that. Those were no. That's as far as I'm going to go with that. Now, my dad is part of that lineage. My earthly dad, I'll say that. Because when I don't deal with race. I deal with the spirit, the bloodline. It's not the same thing as race. It's not the same thing as ethnicity. So I'm choosing my words carefully as the spirit gives it to me. And I grew up in an environment where certain things were going on in bathrooms and things like that. Partly, I had acquaintances, and I love everybody, but as far as close relationships, not too many. But some of them liked me, some of them didn't. When I got to my final year in high school, I was befriended by Samoans, and I got to spend my summer almost every day with a family that is actually royalty throughout the culture and also on the island. And then being in this country, the royalty remains. The last name starts with an N. Those who know, they are royalty. And also, there was another princess. She is royalty. So after I was going into the military, I met other Samoans, and all I had to do was mention the last name, and they were like, "Whoa, you know them?" And I was like, not only do I know them, I slept in their house, they're my family, I still talk to them, I love them so much. The reason I'm bringing this up is because they were brothers and sisters to me. And there was this acceptance the first time. Because when I was born, I'll say that, to make it simple to understand, I started suffering from the day I was born. So people don't really understand what the cross and atonement for all sin that will ever occur or has ever occurred really means. But I do. And I noticed that the family structure of how things were done was you had to respect your elders. If someone was older than you, whoever was older than you was the elder, and you had to listen to them or you would get fussied. And it created this love environment. The younger ones were serving the older ones, and it did not matter opinion. The older one was giving orders. That's what it was. And this really great love environment. So Jesus had a sister, and then a cousin, and then friends that were brothers and sisters, and spent a lot of time with them more than in his own household. It's important you understand that. And that's because my earthly dad was he looked up to and respected Pharisees and Sadducees. And if you don't model the love of Christ in your home, it's going to automatically discredit whatever you're saying, because you're not walking the walk. So there was a lot of that. And I've heard different theories on who the children of Israel are, and Israelites and all of that. So through the Spirit, with the words the Spirit is giving me, tiptoeing but explaining, because I know it's a sensitive topic with people. What I will say, because the Spirit is telling me to say, is Jesus used to kind of get in trouble because Jesus was schooled in a lot of different things. And then in Egypt, a lot of writings were still there, which kind of makes sense because the children of Israel came out of Egypt. So, not only that, almost all religious writings were in Egypt. Then using the Spirit only leads me to truth. I ignore it if it's not truth. And I was talking to my friend about it, and I said, I understand things exist. That does not mean I study them. So, it was written, there was lineage from Jacob, Israel, and there's lineage from Esau. Now, Jesus grew up in the more poor area, Judea, and then you had Israel, which was more, I'm going to say, affluent. Making sure that I'm supposed to be saying all this, checking in with the Spirit and all of that. When I was growing up, so my earthly dad has a lineage to Judah, my earthly mom lineage to Levi. And then this is actually happening. I did not order this, but the Spirit did, through my case manager. My birth certificate is on its way from the state I was actually born in, and that's going to explain so much. People don't understand why it says the genealogy of Jesus Christ in the New Testament. Why that's so important and why it was written down. And using God's word is paramount to everything I do. So a lot of these videos, I'm purposefully through the Spirit, using what's in the Torah to confirm what's in the New Testament, because the two blend. And they complement each other. They say one thing, and then Jesus comes along, fulfills it, and then explains what it meant. And a lot of Jesus's teachings were simply using the Spirit to explain ancient writing to people that did not have a Torah. And I've sat down with a lot of people, and everybody has different theories about this and that, names and all of that. And it really comes down to ego. And the Spirit's telling me to tell you that's not right. And people, why do you believe what you believe? What is your basis, your evidence? How much research have you put into it? How do you know it's truth? Is really what it comes down to. So you have to have the Holy Spirit to have truth. And one thing that I've noticed is archaeologists are saying this doesn't line up with the scripture and all of that, based on the time period. And then on, like, you want to get into carbon 14 dating, you could do that if you really want to. But it makes more sense, if it's that ancient, to be harder to find. And maybe you're looking in the wrong place and thinking the wrong things. So you also have science in itself is backwards. I think these are the steps I'm going to take to prove it. Whereas truth is, I think this, and the truth grabs what you think, and then, so I already know the truth of being gentle about a lot of things. One thing that has escaped many people, if you were chosen to receive the Holy Spirit, because the scripture says many are called, few are chosen, which means you accepted the gift of salvation.